Hello, welcome to 8th session on current electricity. In fact, in this particular session, we'll be focusing on some of these things. Students, you need to remember back all those things that we have covered in my 7th session. We had discussed regarding various types of electrical supply sources like electric cell, and we had understood about their various properties like EMF, internal resistance, factors affecting internal resistance, and some of those intermittent equations that we have learned. Okay, and in this part, we will be majorly focusing on some of these things. And this part happens to be a 5-mark part for your exam point of view. Each of these derivations can be asked for 5 marks. Okay, so let us just take a look at. The first thing that we are going to see is combination of electric cells. Okay, under combination of electric cells, we'll see cells in series, and we will define what is series combination of cells, how we connect them in series, and then we will take a look at expression for equivalent EMF and effective internal resistance for the series combination of cells. Here we'll be considering essentially two cells. Okay. Then some special cases also will observe in this case. Okay, then secondly, we will concentrate on cells in parallel combination, and again here we'll be defining what is a parallel combination of cells, and then we will derive an expression for equivalent EMF and effective internal resistance of parallel combination, and again special cases in this particular part. Okay, and third thing that we will be learning today would be electric power and electric energy. Okay, so these all things combined together, that is going to finish first part of current electricity. Okay, so this is our essential look that we should have. Okay, so let us flow through the discussion of all these things what I have mentioned. Okay, so let's move on. Fine, now let's take a look at the combination of electric cells. First combination that we will be focusing on would be the series combination, so hence we'll have a look at cells in series combination. Let us go ahead and define what is series combination of cells. So two or more cells are said to be in series combination when negative terminal of one cell is connected to positive terminal of another cell, and so on. So like for example, if you just take a look at this diagram, as you can notice here, the negative terminal of one cell is connected to positive terminal. So this is positive terminal here, as you can notice, and here we have negative terminal, and these two are connected with each other. So likewise, all the cells across the combination are connected like that. Okay, so this is how we can visualize regarding cells in series combination. I hope this part is clear. So if you find any difficulty, you can go ahead and ask me. And secondly, we'll just take a look at the symbolic representation of series combination. So how it looks like. So when I represent the same combination that I have shown here diagrammatically, now it's a symbolic representation is like this. As you can notice here, the negative terminal and positive terminal are connected to each other. So this is positive terminal, this is negative terminal, these two are connected to each other, and likewise we have a combination of cells in series here. So I hope this visualization is also clear to you. Fine. So now let's take a look at a furtherance of this. Fine. So now let's go ahead and make a derivation on how equivalent or effective EMF and effective internal resistance can be found in case of series combination. Okay. Now let's have a look at that. Now, in this particular part, we will be focusing majorly on what kind of combination we are talking about. We are talking about series combination. So, firstly, let us go ahead and make a drawing of this combination of two cells in series. So if we just happen to have a look at the circuit diagram, the circuit diagram is as simple like this. As you can notice in this diagram, in between ends A and B, we are connecting two cells in series. As you can notice here, negative terminal of one cell is connected to positive terminal of another cell, and I am showing internal resistance in this diagram. So along with the internal resistance, we can show a cell in this way. I hope you recall my previous session. In the previous session also, I had mentioned regarding this representation including the internal resistance. So this is how we are going to draw a circuit diagram. So I suggest you pause this video and draw this circuit diagram and proceed further. Okay, fine. Then along with this, one more essentially important thing is you must draw an equivalent circuit diagram. Okay, so that equivalent circuit diagram is as shown here. Now here both the cells are replaced by one single cell having EMF ES and internal resistance RS, as you can notice here, and they are this particular cell is placed in between ends A and B again here, right? So this is the equivalent circuit. So when you are writing the answer for this derivation, so you must draw firstly the circuit diagram and then equivalent circuit diagram. Both of them are a must. Okay, now let's take a look at the first prima facie of our derivation. Okay, so first step, we'll say consider two cells of EMFs E1 and E2 with internal resistances R1 and R2 respectively, connected in series combination as shown. Okay, so accordingly, we will define the potentials at three different points. Okay, so I am considering point A, point B and point C. Point C acts as the midpoint between E1 and E2. Okay, two cells E1 and E2. In between these two cells, I am using third point, that is point C. Now this third point acts as a common point between the two cells. Okay, so let us go ahead and assume their potentials to be VA, VB and VC respectively, and accordingly we can go ahead and mention these potential equations. Okay, so in the next step we'll just have a look at that. Fine, now let's go ahead and take a look. Now in this part I'll be proceeding to the next step. So according to the next step that we are having here, so I'm just once again considering the circuit diagrams here for our further reference. Okay, so here potential difference across E1, that is first cell on the left side, E1 is equal to VA minus VC, because there are two points that are on left, we have A, on right we have C. So in between A and C we have a potential difference. Why? Clearly because A is connected to positive terminal, C is connected to negative terminal of first cell. So accordingly we have a potential difference between these two. So that potential difference we are writing as E1 is equal to VA minus VC, which is VAC, that is nothing but what? Terminal potential difference. So if you recall my previous discussion, the terminal potential difference is the potential difference between the two terminals of a cell when the cell is actually conducting the current through the circuit. So obviously the cell is conducting the current now. So accordingly the potential difference between A and C acts as terminal potential difference due to cell E1. And let us consider this as our first equation, and potential terminal potential difference is defined by what? V is equal to E minus IR. So accordingly VAC is equal to E1 minus I into R1 we get. Okay, so similarly I will consider potential difference across E2 as VCB, because again we are having C on right side, C on left side and B on right side of the cell E2. Accordingly we will get second equation as E2 minus I into R2. So adding these two equations, we will be obtaining say VA minus VC plus VC minus VB. So that will give us what? e1 minus I into R1 plus e2 minus I into R2. So in this particular step, next step, what we shall do, we shall simplify that. So if you just observe the VC, which is acting as a bridge between two cells, so minus VC plus VC gets cancelled off. Thus, we will obtain an equation like VA minus VB is equal to E1 plus E2 minus I into R1 plus R2. Now, let us call this as our third equation. So, next we shall assume one single cell. Consider a cell of EMF ES and internal resistance RS, which can equivalently replace these two cells in the circuit. Just like this, as I am just bringing back this equivalent circuit diagram here for your reference. So accordingly, what will be the potential difference between A and B here, across A and B? That is terminal potential difference due to cell ES. So accordingly, VA minus VB will be equal to what? ES minus I into RS. Okay. So if you just compare third and fourth equation now. Fourth equation we have derived already. So comparing 3 and 4, so we can comfortably say ES is equal to E1 plus E2 and RS is equal to R1 plus R2. So this is the final answer that we are supposed to obtain. So I hope these two steps are clear, as well as the derivation steps are very, very comfortable and easy to be followed. I have explained them in a easy narrative manner. So I suggest wherever you get stuck up, okay, kindly pause the video, replay it and observe how it has been derived. Okay, now let's move on to the next step, that is special cases. So finally, let us sum up what we have learned here. Okay, so hence in case of a series combination of cells, we can say that first point, equivalent EMF ES is equal to what? Sum of individual EMFs. Okay. And second point that we can observe is equivalent internal resistance, that we have called it as RS, and RS is equal to what? Sum of individual internal resistances. I hope this is quite evidently clear from the derivation that we have made. Okay. Now let's move on to the next step. Now let's go ahead and take a look at special cases involved in case of series combination. So first special case, we'll say n number of cells connected in series. Under that particular scenario, we can write ES is equal to what? E1 plus E2 plus so on up to EN. Similarly, RS will be equal to what? R1 plus R2 plus so on up to RN. So it is just similar to your series combination of resistances. I hope this is quite easily rememberable. So you can memorize this equation in order to complete your numerical problems. When you are solving the numerical problems, at that moment of time, you need to recall these equations. Okay. So this is first special case. Second special case, we'll say consider n number of cells having same internal resistance small r and having same EMF capital E. Under that particular situation, ES will be equal to what? Sum of E up to n times, so which is n into E, very clearly. And RS will be equal to what? Just similar to your series combination of resistances, we can write n into small r. So these are two special cases that are involved in case of series combination of cells. Okay, I hope this part is clear. Now let's proceed to our next particular discussion. Let's consider the second variety of combination of electric cells, that is parallel combination. So cells in parallel combination, if you just observe this via definition, so let us go ahead and take a look at the definition of parallel combination. Okay, so two or more cells are said to be connected in parallel if positive terminals of all cells are connected to one point and their negative terminals are connected to another point. So this is very simple to remember. Negative terminals are connected together at one point and positive terminals are connected together at another point. So this is parallel combination. This is how you can make out the difference between series and parallel combination. Now let's take a look at visualization of this. Okay, I'll just show you the combination of cells in parallel. As you can notice here, very interestingly, you can see all positive terminals are connected together and all negative terminals are connected together here, and thus we are having each of these cells in parallel combination. I hope now the visualization is very clear. Okay, so you can try it out at home by considering two or more cells to connect and connect them in parallel combination or series combination like this. Okay, I hope this visualization is clear to you. Now let us take a look at symbolic representation of this particular diagram. Okay, so if you want to symbolically represent parallel combination of resistors, as you can notice here, all positive terminals are connected together here and all negative terminals are connected together. So accordingly we can visualize that these cells are in parallel. So this is a very simple approach that you can remember. Fine. So now let's move ahead with the discussion on derivation for an expression for equivalent EMF and equivalent internal resistance in parallel combination. Okay. Now for this particular derivation, again we will just consider this circuit diagram as you are seeing here. So the circuit diagram contains two cells connected in parallel combination because their positive terminals are connected together here, as you can notice. Okay, and negative terminals are connected together like this. Okay, so accordingly we can comfortably understand that these two cells are connected in parallel combination, and we are saying that negative terminals are connected towards a common point called B2. Okay, whereas positive terminals are connected to a common point called B1. Okay, so B1 and B2 are two terminal points for this particular combination of cells, and we are considering their internal resistances also, like R1 and R2, as you can notice here, and their current flowing through each of the cells, we are considering them to be I1 and I2, and I1 and I2, they combine to form a common current called I here. Okay, I hope this circuit is clear. So you just need to remember the approach of drawing the circuit. Please remember. Okay, fine. Now let's take a look at second step. We should draw an equivalent circuit diagram. So that equivalent circuit diagram can be drawn like this. Here we are showing two common points, B1 and B2. In between B1 and B2, we are considering EP and internal resistance RP, one single cell. Okay, and this is called as the equivalent circuit diagram, and this is a must. You must draw this diagram during the derivation process. Okay, so let us move on to the derivation. First step, we'll make some considerations as usual. Okay, so we'll say consider two cells of EMF E1 and E2 with internal resistances R1 and R2 respectively, connected in parallel between two points B1 and B2 as shown. Okay, and my friends, in this particular derivation, one more important thing that you should remember is, in case of parallel combination, potential difference is same. This fact you please remember. Okay, now let's move on to the second point, that is I1 and I2 are the currents flowing towards B1 from each of the cells, as we are observing, as I have already explained to you. So I1 and I2 can be observed in the circuit. So this is where we are moving ahead with our next step, that is we should mention about current I. So hence we are mentioning current I is the current flowing out from this particular combination. Okay, so now let's move on to the next step of the derivation. Okay, now let's move on to the next step. So in this next step, we can say, as cells are in parallel, so definitely cells are in parallel, so therefore potential difference across both the cells is same. What kind of potential difference I'm talking about? I'm talking about terminal potential difference. Okay, so obviously the terminal potential difference across both of the cells will be one and the same. Okay, so accordingly we can say PD between terminals of E1 can be very easily written as what? VB1 minus VB2. And this VB1 minus VB2 is exactly same as what? PD between terminals of E2. So obviously PD between terminals of E1 and E2 are one and the same, and I am calling that potential difference as capital V, and that capital V is nothing but VB1 minus VB2. Okay. Next step. So as you can notice here, hence we can write V is equal to E1 minus I1 into R1. Right. So this is terminal potential difference, V is equal to E minus IR, that I am writing here. Okay. Again, therefore, I'll derive an expression for I1. I1 is equal to E1 minus V divided by R1. Let us consider this as our second equation, that is equation number 2. Okay. First equation, that was I is equal to I1 plus I2, that we have already seen. Okay. Next, again, we'll follow the same approach. So hence, again, for cell E2, we can say V is equal to E2 minus I2 into R2. So accordingly, I2 will be equal to what? E2 minus V divided by R2. So let us call this as third equation. Okay. Now let's move on to the next step here. Now let us recall back. I is equal to I1 plus I2. So accordingly, we can comfortably add these two equations. Equations are 2 and 3. Okay. So if we just add both of them, then we can simplify it in this form. I is equal to E1 by R1 plus E2 by R2 minus V into 1 by R1 plus 1 by R2. I hope it is not rocket science. You people can very easily arrive at this particular step. Okay. Then next step, we'll take LCM here. So by taking LCM, we can write E1 R2 plus E2 R1 divided by R1 R2 minus V into R1 plus R2 divided by R1 R2. So by taking LCM, we are getting this. Very simple. So accordingly, let us proceed to the next step here. So accordingly, over here, we can comfortably take this equation to the form of V is equal to something, because I need to get terminal potential difference form. So hence, I'll write this as V into bracket R1 plus R2 divided by R1 R2 will be equal to what? E1 R2 plus E2 R1 divided by R1 R2 minus I. Just simple transformation of LHS and RHS. Okay, we have obtained this. Okay, so again, thus we can write V is equal to what? This entire RHS part divided by second half of LHS part. Correct. So hence, comfortably I can write this as E1 R2 plus E2 R1 divided by R1 R2 minus I whole divided by R1 plus R2 divided by R1 R2. It's a reciprocal, can be written as a multiple here, which is R1 R2 divided by R1 plus R2. Okay. So now next step, we need to convert this in the form of V is equal to E minus IR. So hence we will go ahead and simplify this further, and we can write this as V is equal to E1 R2 plus E2 R1 divided by R1 plus R2. How did we get this? Simply by multiplying the extreme right hand part, that is this one, we will multiply inside here. So if we multiply it in here, so we can very comfortably obtain this. Okay, so we have obtained the potential difference equation like this. Is it clear? Okay, so hence we can write V is equal to E1 R2 plus E2 R1 divided by R1 plus R2 minus I into R1 R2 divided by R1 plus R2. Okay, so this is a very simple fourth equation that we have obtained. Now, friends, is it not in the form of V is equal to E minus IR? Let us explore that further. Okay, now let us move ahead with our next step like this. Now, what we shall do here, we shall consider one single cell again, one single cell of EMF EP and internal resistance RP, just similar to what we have done in series combination. So likewise, here I am considering EP and RP as EMF and internal resistance, so that which can replace both the cells E1 and E2 between B1 and B2. Then the circuit will be like this, equivalent circuit. By replacing those two, I am introducing one single cell. Okay, so accordingly, I can very comfortably mention terminal potential difference due to this particular single cell as V is equal to EP minus I into RP. I am taking this as fifth equation. So accordingly, now simple thing is what? Cakewalk. we should compare equation 5 with equation 4. So very clearly equation 4 and 5 are compared. So hence we obtain EP is equal to what? E1 R2 plus E2 R1 divided by R1 plus R2. See how simple it is. Second, we can very easily write RP is equal to R1 R2 divided by R1 plus R2. Right? So these two are what? These two are equivalent equations for EMF and internal resistance. Fine. So we have obtained our required solution, my friends. But this is not the end of it. We should again explore and convert this into something better form for our numerical problems. Okay, so that also we'll just explore in our next step. I hope this part is clear. Now let's move on to the next step. For the numerical problems, equation or expression that we have obtained, it might not be of that use in some cases. So hence let us reduce this back to some useful form, because now that form is that derived form that we have, it can be utilized only when two cells are given. Okay, what if more than two cells are given? That particular form cannot be applied, my friends. So hence let us take a look at another useful form of this by a simple division. Okay, so what we can do here, we can reduce it to some useful form by dividing EP and RP that we obtained in previous equation, correct? So if we just divide that physically, okay, then we can comfortably obtain this particular form. EP by RP is equal to E1 by R1 plus E2 by R2, and 1 by RP is equal to 1 by R1 plus 1 by R2, right? So very clearly we can move on to this general form now. As you can notice, this general form as EP by RP is equal to E1 by R1 plus E2 by R2 plus so on up to En by Rn. This is general form. Now let there be any number of cells, we can comfortably derive that equivalent EMF from this particular expression. Similarly, RP can be derived by using parallel combination of resistance formula. 1 by RP is equal to 1 by R1 plus 1 by R2 so on up to 1 by Rn. Okay, and one advice, my friends, if you are making use of this particular equation in finding EMF, firstly you find RP, first you calculate RP, then substitute that RP here, then only you will be able to obtain that required value. Okay, so this can act as a shortcut for you. Okay, so please remember this approach and this formula. These two set of formulae are quite important heart of your problems. Okay, so kindly remember this. That is why I'm repeating again and again. Please do remember these two equations. Okay, so now let's proceed to our next step, my friends. So our next step would be a quite easy stop for us. Now let's take a look at that special cases. Okay, now let's take a look at special cases. First special case is already been discussed, and we have listed those two equations as well. So this is the equation that we have obtained in my previous part as a last step of our derivation. Okay, then second special case, I'll consider n number of cells of same EMFs and same internal resistances. If they are connected in parallel, then I can very easily write EP is equal to E here. If you just work it out by using the above equation in special case 1, what equation I have mentioned, if you just work it out, then you should be able to get EP is equal to E only. Okay, and RP is equal to R by N. So this is special case number 2, and these two special cases you please remember while solving the problems, especially entrance exam based problems. Okay, so these two equations, special case equations, will come in handy. Okay, so this is about parallel combination. I hope this entire part of discussion is clear to you. Now let's move on to our next part of discussion. Let's take a look at the last part of current electricity part 1, that is electric power and electric energy. Because without power and energy, nothing in this universe can be established, right? So obviously, similar to that particular statement, I can say if you are making use of current, then it will consume some power, okay? So that power you should be able to calculate. For example, in your household devices, the power ratings are different. For refrigerator, power rating is different. For mixer grinder, power rating is different. Okay. As a matter of fact, each of these power ratings will combine in the end of the month, and that will come as an electricity bill to you. So obviously, you should be smart enough to make a calculation well in advance as to like how much power I can utilize and how much power I can save, because everything is saving, my friends. So obviously, this particular concept is an introduction towards that. Okay, so we will try to understand what is electric power and what is electric energy. That's all. Okay, so let's firstly assume some things. If I say capital V is the potential difference across some resistance capital R, and current I is flowing through this particular resistance, then under this situation, I can say a potential difference V is equal to what? Work done in bringing a unit charge from one point to another point. So obviously, is it not work done by charge? So hence, W by Q is potential difference for us, my friends. So accordingly, I can say W is equal to what? Q into V. So W, that is work done, will be charge multiplied by potential difference, and potential difference in common man's language, it is called as what? Voltage, right? So work done is nothing but product of charge and voltage. So that we have obtained now, fine. Now let's calculate power. Power is what? Rate of doing work. So is it not a simple derivative of work? So dW by dt, which is nothing but what? Power. So hence, let's go ahead and differentiate W is equal to Q into V with respect to time. So accordingly, I can very easily write d by dt of Q into V as what? D by dt of Q into V can be written as V into dq by dt. And what is dq by dt, my friends? Electric current. So simple. So thus, we obtain power P is equal to V into I, which is nothing but potential difference multiplied by electric current. Okay, and over here, a simple reason for replacing dq by dt is dq by dt is rate of flow of charge with respect to time, which is nothing but what? Electric current. So this simple definition and formula you please remember. So what is electrical power, my friends? Then is it not the product of potential difference or voltage and electric current, right? So this is what we have obtained. Now let's take a look at some of the other forms of this particular equation. Now, other forms of power equation that we have obtained. Now, first form, I will take it like this. As V is equal to I into R, from Ohm's law, I know that. Okay, very simple. So if I substitute that in my P is equal to VI equation, then I'll get P is equal to I into R into I, which is nothing but I square into R. So very clearly, power P is equal to I square into R. Now, my friends, we have obtained the power equation in terms of current and resistance. Okay, and this particular equation that we have obtained here, no, this equation is going to help you a lot in calculating the amount of heat produced by a resistance. Okay, usually electric current produces heat energy, and that amount of heat energy produced can be calculated by using this particular equation, P is equal to I square into R. Okay, now let us take a look at second form. As I is equal to V by R, again I am considering Ohm's law. So if I substitute I is equal to V by R, then very clearly P is equal to V into I. So here I can be replaced by V by R. So hence I will get power P is equal to what? V square divided by R. So now I have obtained power equation in terms of voltage or potential difference and the resistance. Okay. Now these are two interesting forms that you can remember while solving the power based equations in case of entrance exams. Okay, I hope this part is comfortably clear. Now let's take a look at energy, how we can define electrical energy by using these forms. Now this is quite easy, evidently easy, because electrical energy or energy can be very easily calculated by using power. Okay, because I know that power is equal to energy, power is equal to work by time, and energy is nothing but work from work energy principle. So let us combine this and find the expression for energy, electrical energy. So accordingly, energy is equal to work done, that is equal to power multiplied by time. So if I multiply simply the power equation with the time, then I'll get like this: electrical energy is equal to V into I into T, or I square into R into T, or V square divided by R into T, right? So we have obtained the electrical energy equation, as you can notice here. Okay, so my dear friends, hereby we are done with our first part. But before I proceed further, I would like to define one commercial unit for electrical energy. That also I'll just mention before I wind up. Okay, so commercial unit of electrical energy is kilowatt hour. Okay, so I hope you would have heard about kilowatt hour n number of times. So kilowatt hour, which is small k capital W, H is the symbol. So 1 kilowatt hour is 3.6 into 10 raised to 6 joule, and its a derivation I'm leaving it to you people. Okay, so I hope this part is clear, and any further queries that you have on this particular session as well as previous sessions of mine, kindly get in touch with me and have your doubts clarified. Okay, so by this particular session I am closing or finishing the first part of current electricity, my friends. Okay, so next part would be on Kirchhoff's law, that is electrical measurement and electrical complex electrical circuits. Okay, so that we will see in my next session. Okay, so until then, I suggest you people to be prepared with the derivations that we have discussed here. Okay, all those things that we have discussed previously. Okay, you please list them down, practice them thoroughly. Okay, and be 100% accurate in the learning process. Fine. So lastly, so we have discussed all these parts comfortably, so kindly prepare them, practice each of the derivations and equations. Okay, remember all the formulae and be thorough. So that I'm just coming back with my video lecture session on problems. Okay, so I'll be sending you the problems, list of problems in the group. Okay, kindly download those problems, and I'll solve those problems in my next video session. And these problems are pertaining to first part of current electricity, and each of these problems are worth 5 mark or 3 mark in your annual examination. So before that, I'm mentioning once again, please be thorough with each of the formula and derivations and equations. Okay, thank you then. I'll see you all soon with my problem session. Thank you then.